Dear students, very pleasant good morning to all of you. In the previous lecture, we were discussing about the control measurements of air pollution, and in the previous lecture, we discussed about how to control suspended particulate matter before getting it into the atmosphere. So many devices we mentioned there, and the devices were electrostatic precipitator, cyclone separator, packet bag filters or bag filters or wet scrubbers. These were the devices which we generally use for controlling the suspended particulate matter. And today we are going to discuss about the control measurements of the pollutant which are gaseous in nature. Means there are gaseous pollutants emitting from different industries with nitrogen oxide, carbon monoxide, carbon dioxide, sulfur oxide and hydrocarbons and so many other gases releasing from the industrial source or from any other factories or the operating units which are directly being released into the atmosphere. And to control the gaseous pollutants, we have different methods and different approaches, and we shall try to discuss what are the methods, what are the measurements, what are the measures to control the gaseous pollutants. Control of gaseous pollutants. There are different methods of controlling the gaseous pollutants from being released into the to release into the atmosphere. In the methods may be, there are absorption method, and another one is there are adsorption method is there. There are other methods which we known as incineration method, and so many other methods are there. But as per the demand of the syllabus, we are going to explain you the few methods of gaseous pollution control. And the first very method we are going to discuss is simply the absorption method. Absorption simply means when any substance gets dissolved into any other substance. For example, generally the gases in the atmosphere get dissolved in the oceans or in the other water bodies. Exactly following on the same principle, we have absorption method for controlling the gaseous pollutants emitting from different industries, and how these gaseous pollutants are being removed by the process of absorption method. We use different chemical substances as solvents. The substances are lime celery we can use. We can use magnesium hydroxide in solution form, aqueous form. We can use hydrochloric acid, and we can use lime celery, magnesium hydroxide, sulfuric acid or calcium hydroxide, waste caustic ammonia liquor and ammonium bisulfite. These are some of the solvents we are using for industrial gaseous pollutants to remove. What are the mechanism? What is the mechanism of this removal of absorption by different solutions, by different solvents present in our industrial sectors? And these are, the mechanism is so simple. The gaseous pollutants, released from any particular industrial source. Say for example, this is the chimney of the industrial source from which the gaseous pollutants like nitrogen oxide, sulfur oxide, carbon dioxide, carbon monoxide and so many other pollutants are being released. And what we do, we put a solution here. For example, as we can take water as well as a solution. Sodium hydroxide is there. Sodium hydroxide. And so many other solution, so many other solvents is already discussed. For example, lime celery we can use. We can use magnesium hydroxide, sulfuric acid. And these are the solvents we use to remove the gaseous pollutants from being emitting from any particular industrial source. And what we do, we allow this is the solvent we use as slime, slurry, or so many water itself can also be used as sodium hydroxide is there. And these are the solvent. This is a solvent actually. And we allow these pollutants, gaseous pollutant, to pass through these solvents as the gaseous pollutants like carbon dioxide, nitrogen oxide, and so many other gases are there, comes in contact with the solvent present here. This is a solvent. It gets dissolved here, and the carbon dioxide, nitrogen oxide, or sulfur oxides are being dissolved in these very solvents already present in the particular tank, and removal of or the clean air gas gets emitting from this very site. It means, what is the mechanism of absorption? Mechanism of absorption simply means we allow the polluted gases like nitrogen oxide, sulfur oxide, carbon dioxide, carbon monoxide, and so many other gases emitting from any particular industry, and allow these pollutant gases to pass through any solvent which I mentioned here. Water can be taken as solvent, hydrogen, sodium hydroxide is there, slime, slurry is there, and the pollutant gases are passed through these substances, and these easily get absorbed in these very solvents, and the amount of gaseous pollutants get dissolved here. As a result, cleaning of the gaseous pollutant takes place by the way of absorption method. The next method is the adsorption method. What happens in case of adsorption method? Adsorption means this is, for example, a particular material we are having as an adsorbent. We allow the gaseous molecules, the pollutants especially, to pass through these. For example, we allow the gaseous particle, gaseous substance to pass through these. The next method is adsorption method. What happens in case of adsorption method? For example, this is a substance on which we are supposed to, by the help of which we are supposed to remove the gaseous pollutants emitting from any particular industry. Then what happens? We actually pass the gaseous substances through these substances, and what happens, the mechanism is that the gaseous substance get attached onto the surface of such substances and gets removed. Means we allow the pollutant gases emitting from any particular industry like nitrogen oxide, sulfur oxide, carbon dioxide, monoxide, and so many other gaseous pollutant emitting from the particular industry. We allow such gaseous pollutants to pass through the substances which can adsorb the gaseous pollutants onto the surface of itself, and the mechanism of attachment of any gaseous pollutant or any substance onto the surface of any particular material or any particular substance is known as adsorption. And in case of adsorption, what happens? For example, these are the gaseous substances. emitting from any particular industry, and what happens, this gets attached onto the surface of these adsorbents already used. And the most important and the most efficient removal of gaseous pollutant is the activated carbon. Means activated carbon is such a substance which is used to remove the gaseous pollutant, and what happens, the gaseous pollutants are passed or allowed to pass through the activated carbon, and activated carbon gets adsorb the gaseous pollutant from being comes in contact with such substances, and the activated carbon attaches the gaseous pollutant onto the surface of itself, and removal of gaseous pollutants takes place. Two different types of activated carbon is there. One is non-regenerative, and one is regenerative. What happens in case of non-regenerative bed? There is only a single bed of activated carbon, and on gets saturation, as the activated carbon beds get saturated with the gaseous pollutant, it is supposed to be removed. But in case of regenerative activated carbon, what happens? There are series of number of beds are already lying one over the other, and these are activated carbons. As the upper bed gets saturated with gaseous pollutant, this the upper bed of the activated carbon is removed, and the next bed of activated carbon is ready to adsorb the gaseous pollutant comes in contact with it. So this is the mechanism of activated carbon. Then we can use so many materials, so many substances as adsorbent, and these are silica gel. We can use, the mechanism is same as in case of this activated carbon, and we can use also molecular sieves, and we can use ion exchange resins, we can use also manganese and ferric oxide. These are the substances we can use to remove the gaseous pollutant. Means when we pass the gaseous pollutant, be it nitrogen oxide, sulfur oxide, or other gaseous pollutant emitting from any particular industry, these are acted as adsorbents, and these having got the capability to adsorb the gaseous pollutants onto the surface of itself, attach the gaseous pollutant onto the surface of itself, and as a result, we remove the gaseous pollutant from this mechanism, which we known as adsorption method. We have another method which we can say incineration. What happens in case of incineration? We use, for example, a pollutant is being emitting from any particular source, and here is that chamber. We say it is a thermal chamber. And the gaseous pollutants are passed through this thermal chamber, where the temperature is already raised, and incineration or combustion takes place in this very chamber, and the conversion of most toxic gases to carbon dioxide and water takes place, which are comparatively are negligible in case of pollutant nature is concerned. Means carbon dioxide is not going to be very poisonous gas, and the water itself is not a pollutant at all. So in case of incineration, what we do, we allowed to pass the gaseous pollutant through any particular chamber which has already been supplied with oxygen and heating, and the combustion takes place in this very chamber, which we call this a thermal chamber, as a result of which conversion of more toxic substance into carbon dioxide and water takes place. Then the next method is besides this, there are so many approaches through which we can control water pollution. There is a proper mechanism of siting of industry. Means before establishment of industry, a particular industry is supposed to take a permission or consent from the concerned board, be it CPCB, Central Pollution Control Board, or State Pollution Control Board, as the case may be. And there is already a zonation has already been made, the industrial areas, commercial areas, silent zone, and so many other zones. So the industries are only set up away from the cities, away from the agriculture areas, and it also contributes a lot for controlling air pollution. So siting of industry is significantly important as far as the pollution control is concerned. The next is switch on to the cleaner fuel. So many there we are using actually coal in diesel, but we can switch over to such fuels which are cleaner in nature. Say for example, there are CNGs are there and so many other fuels. Then desulfurization means the coal is having too much sulfur content, and the sulfur content before using sulfur coal, what we are supposed to do, we are actually removing the sulfur from the coals, and the process is known as desulfurization, means removal of sulfur, then the coal is being used for the combustion purposes. Then cleaner technologies, what we are to do, we are to remove the older conventional technologies which are being used in different sectors, be it industries, factories or automobiles. So new and cleaner technologies which use minimum amount of fossil fuels and releases maximum amount of calorific value, so that lesser amount of pollutant can be released into the atmosphere. And then mass transportation system can also be a significant source, because using a personal vehicle is contributing very high amount of pollutant into the atmosphere. But we can also use the concept of carpooling and public transportation, and such approach contributes a lot in controlling pollutant. Then we can also have a final this mass awareness or public awareness. Is there is a well-known I think a Chinese proverb is there, if you plan for 1 year, then plant rice is within a stipulated time period of 1 year you can reap the rice, and if you plan for 10 years, then go for plantation of trees, means plant trees. And if you are planning for hundreds and hundreds of years, then what we are supposed to do, we are supposed to educate the people about the mechanism, about the pros and cons of the industries, factories, or the pollution itself. So what we are supposed to do, we are supposed to educate the people about the causes, consequences, and control measurements of air pollution. Hope you got understand the control measurements of air pollution, be it gaseous pollutant or suspended particulate pollutants. Then in the next very lecture, hopefully we are going to discuss about the water pollution, its causes, consequences, and how to control the water pollutants. Till then, stay home, stay safe. Best of luck.